Setting up a G Suite account can be a daunting endeavor, especially if you don't really like the tech side of running a coaching business. But don't fret, I've got your back. In this video, I'll take you by my hand and we will set up step by step your new professional email address in G Suite in a matter of minutes rather than hours, days, or maybe even weeks. By the way, hi, I'm Sabine Weisenberger, and if we haven't met yet, welcome to my YouTube channel where I share everything marketing and beyond to help you grow your coaching business. And if you're already part of my community, welcome back. You look stunning as always. Now, if you haven't signed up for a G Suite account yet, hop over to sabineb.cc/G Suite and register for the basic account. It comes with a 14 days free trial, so you can play around a little bit before you commit. Personally, I use the basic account and organize everything within this single account by using aliases, filters, and labels. If you're interested in learning everything about G Suite, make sure to subscribe to my channel as I will cover this topic soon. Now let's switch over to the computer and log into the G Suite account to get this setup underway. Now I've just signed up for the basic account here, clicked start free trial, and filled in all the information required until I've reached this page here. So once you've completed your initial sign up, click to go to setup. Wait a little bit. Then click next with a pop-up window here. And you're on this page here. The first thing that we need to do, I used the domain sabine.tv. We need to activate our account. So let's do this right now. So the next step that we need to do is sign in to activate and link our existing domain to our new G Suite account. So in my case, I, for example, bought the domain sabine.tv at GoDaddy, and G Suite automatically recognized that. Now you may need to have here Namecheap or Crazy Domain or domain.com. So make sure that the selection that they offer you here is correct. And if yes, click sign in to activate, or if it's incorrect, go to or switch verification method. So let's click sign in to activate. A pop-up window will show up, and for me, it shows the access information that I need to type in to access my GoDaddy account. Now, as I said, for you, this might be Namecheap or Crazy Domain or domain.com, or if you already have an existing website that is live, it's most likely that you transferred your domain or URL over to them, and that means that you need to log in to maybe Squarespace, Bluehost, SiteGround, or maybe WordPress Engine, whoever is your website host. So let's click authorize. Then you need to sign in with the login information that you've created when you set up your basic account with G Suite. Now you can see that G Suite did everything for us and the system is now busy to verifying that we own sabine.tv or whatever your domain is, and they update the email settings with GoDaddy. It says 5 minutes left, so let's do a little bit of a time warp. Okay, so the activation process has been completed and G Suite communicated directly with my GoDaddy account to get the settings right. As I'm the only user, I'm actually happy with the single account that I personally created for myself. However, what I want to do is work with email aliases, and I will show you that one in a later video. So for now, click or skip for now. Now you can see what we still need to do. We need to send a test email. If you want, you can create additional users. Let's say if you would have a virtual assistant or another co-founder of your company. And you can see you can migrate different things, enhance your email security and all that cool stuff. So let's first send a test email. Let's click go to Gmail at the bottom. Let's click next here and let's click OK here. And now you can see in the inbox should be that test email that I've got. And ta-da, it's actually here. We've got the test email for Sabine TV. Now, for the sake of this exercise, I just want to compose a new email. and send it to a test email address. And let's click send. I will now quickly check my inbox, so give me a second, if we received this email. And ta-da, I've just received the test email. So this means your G Suite account is all set. Now that you can send already emails back and forth in just a couple of minutes, let's quickly check what other apps you have access to within the G Suite package. There is the calendar functionality, as well as obviously the Google Drive. To access those, you can either click this little icon over here, which gives you a preview of your calendar. But if you prefer, like me, the full screen version, click on those little 9 dots at the top of the page, then go to calendar, which is over here. Now the sequence of those icons might be different in your case, but you can see it's named with calendar and the icon is pretty obvious too. So let's click that one. You can see that a new window is opening up, and in there you have obviously a different calendar view. You can do change the weeks to day, to month, to year. You can jump from one month to the other. You can set up meetings, for example, just like you are used in your normal calendar functionality. And the coolest thing that I personally like is you can also use the Google Drive. So to access this, let's jump back to our Gmail account and then click again the 9 little dots. You can also access it from your calendar over here. So let's do that one. Let's click the 9 little dots. Then you can see here you can access the Google Drive, or you can jump directly into Sheets, Docs, or Slides and do all the other things as well. However, I want to show you the Google Drive first. So let's click this one. The Google Drive is more or less similar to what you have in Windows with the Explorer. It's a management system, but within the G Suite account, you also get storage space. And you can organize your Google Drive similar like you would do it in the Explorer, or if you have a Mac in the Finder. To do that, simply click the plus new button here and you see the options. You can create a new folder, you can upload files, you can upload folders, or you can create different documents. Now, Google Docs is similar to Word, Google Sheets to Excel, and Google Slides to, for example, PowerPoint or Keynotes. So for the sake of this activity, let's quickly set up a folder. So let's click plus folder. Let's call it test folder, and it would be great if I could spell. Let's click create. And you can see that your test folder is now showing up here. Now, if you want to create, let's say, a document, click on Google Plus Docs. The document is opening up. And you can see when you only type in one letter, it's immediately taken over as the header. Let's say we don't want this, we want to call it differently. And you actually don't need to click save or anything else, because Google is automatically saving everything for you. Now let's close this file and let's assume we would be happy with it. And let's just refresh our view, and you should now see our test file is here in the quick access bar. It's also down here. So in the quick access, you would see normally all the files that you've accessed, edited, changed, or viewed in a matter of time. Let's say maybe within the last 10 minutes, depends on how many different documents you open up and close and edit, or you can always search for them here, or you can see them down there and you can sort with a name, or for example, move it around a little bit. And that's kind of it. Done and dusted! Your G Suite email account is all set, and you can now send emails back and forth, manage your time by using the calendar functionality, create and save files by using the Google Drive, and so much more. Exciting and productive times ahead. As mentioned at the beginning, make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell if you want to learn more about how to set up aliases, labels, and filters, and if you want to learn other marketing strategies and automation. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends and peers. And as always, I appreciate you being here and watching my YouTube videos. If you want to learn more about what kind of videos I produce, make sure to click this thumbnail here, or maybe this one over here. Bye for now, and I'll see you in the next one.